Hello everyone and welcome. Today I'm painting a portrait of Frida Kahlo, and even though it's not the first portrait I have painted, it still was a bit of a challenge. Maybe because of the size of the painting. This is A3, so it's twice the paper size I usually go for. Or the fact that I'm not very good at painting flowers, and flowers are a big part of this painting. But I do enjoy painting this kind of whimsical portraits with illustrative style. So I decided why not to paint the beautiful Frida, and so I did. You will see some weird camera angles in this video and change of lighting, and sorry about all that. I'm using white nights and Schmincke watercolors and Arches 300 grams hot pressed paper. Here I just had to try to paint at least one of the flowers to have peace of mind that I can make it look like a flower. I will come back to painting the flowers later. I just had to try one. I really really love watercolor flowers, but I think they're quite hard to paint, and I think the flowers were that part of the painting I was kind of scared to mess up, and I feel like I kind of messed up one of the flowers, but I mean at the end it just blends with the rest of the piece, so it's all good. I went with the traditional Dewana style clothing she mostly wore and the red scarf. I watched a documentary about her, which I absolutely loved, just to get some ideas about the clothing and accessories and even the flowers. Even though I still went for the flowers, I could just draw. But yeah, anyway, I really liked her in the blue dress, and I thought the blue, yellow and red will go together nice and will complement each other. If you haven't seen that documentary, I will link it down below. Here I'm doing the scarf. I forgot to turn on the camera sooner, that's why you can only see tiny part of it. But I ended up doing wet on wet and using this really deep red. I think it's called dark red. It's one of Schmincke's color. And for shadows I used violet and eventually indigo. And yeah, the scarf is also one of the parts of the painting I'm really, really happy. I tried to film as close as possible so you could see the details and everything. The technique I went for, mostly with those rose kind of flowers, was I took the paint right from the pan with a damp brush and applied it on the edge of the petal. And then came in with a clean wet brush and kind of like drew the paint further to the petal, if you know what I mean. If you can see, I actually even have two separate brushes, one for the color and one for the clean water. So I wouldn't waste time rinsing the brush and also not wasting the paint. And then with a clean napkin, I patted some of the wet area to make it lighter and also give more shadow to other areas. So yeah, that's the plan I had. That's the technique I used. I think it worked out quite fine. This red flower at the back is the flower I messed up. I don't know how I didn't notice that I'm making it way too dark, but I did, and I really felt it takes away all the attention from the other flowers. So yeah, I just left it like this for some time. I didn't finish it right away. I had to think about what to do, what to do with this, how to fix this. Thank you. Okay, this is a bit, yeah, this is the weird angle I was talking about. I feel like tilting my head while watching this. So, last touches for the flowers with colored pencils to give some texture and do the outlines. Again, just something I like to do. I was actually holding the paper block like against the side of the table, like upright. It was the only way I could see what I was doing and also film. So final touches for the face, again with the colored pencil. I also use a white pencil. And here I actually felt that the hair was too like bland. So I mixed some black and blue gouache and tried to give this kind of braided hair look. And I actually think the blue hairband and the blue highlights like complemented each other. And yeah, some more colored pencil here and there, and we are done. This is how the painting came out. I hope you enjoyed the video. You can like and subscribe if you did. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.